Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmano from veenaasmano.com. I hope you're ready for another recipe from me. This is my cottage pie. It's a ground beef topped with mashed potatoes. It's absolutely simple, easy and delicious recipe. You can make both the components separately and then assemble it just an hour before you are ready to eat. So let's get started. I'm going to start with the mashed potato. You can do both of these things simultaneously. So I've got mashed potato that I've boiled until it's nice and soft, and then I'm going to mash it with my potato masher. You can also use a ricer, but I like a little bite. Now I added a little bit of butter. I'm also going to add some cheese and some Parmesan, and then I'm going to season it with some salt and pepper. I'm going to try as much as I can to mash it, but I'm going to leave a few chunks in there because I do like a little bite. I'm going to set this aside while I prepare my ground beef. Now for my ground beef, I'm using a cast iron skillet because I'm going to bake in this as well. So I've got oil with onion. I'm going to add some carrots and some celery. This is my mise en place. And I'm going to saute until the onions are nice and translucent. Today I'm using ground beef with a little bit of sausage meat. If you don't have sausage meat, you can also use two slices of bacon, but you do want to have that extra bit of sausage meat or bacon inside because it does add boost up the flavor. So I'm going to put the meat in there with the I've ground both of them together, the sausage meat and the ground beef. You can see it's quite fatty. You don't want it too lean, but you don't want too much of fat as well. Now you want to cook this beef until it's no longer pink, kind of try and brown it up a bit. I now added the garlic, and I'm going to add in some crushed tomatoes. This is about half a can of crushed tomatoes. I'm going to give that a good mix, and I'm going to cook this for about 8 minutes. Next, I want to season this with some salt and pepper. I'm also going to add some parsley and thyme. I've put them both together. I'm going to give that a good mix. Now, I do want a little bit of sauce inside because once I bake it, it'll lose some of its moisture. So I'm going to add a little bit of water or stock inside, and I'm going to kind of bring it to a boil. Next, I'm going to top it up with my mashed potato. I've already started my preheating my oven, and I'm going to just put spoonfuls all over the ground beef. This is the best way to actually spread the mashed potato without all the juices getting mixed up into the mashed potato. You can see I'm just dropping spoonfuls. After that, I will take the back of my spoon and spread evenly so I have a nice even surface. Next, I'm going to spread some Parmesan cheese and some cheddar cheese on top. I'm going to bake this in my preheated oven for about 20 minutes at 200 degrees Celsius, 400 degrees Fahrenheit. When it's baked, you should have something like this, a nice golden little crisp crust on top. It's a very simple and easy recipe. I'm just going to top it up with some parsley. Don't forget to wait for at least 10 minutes before you cut into this, because the ground beef on the bottom is really hot. And if you like this recipe, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. The full recipe for this is on my blog with progress pictures. I will leave the link below or in the recipe card on top. And I hope you try this recipe. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give this a thumbs up, and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. If you try my recipe, don't forget to tag me on any social media, Veena Asmanov. I'll see you in another video.